Hello! In this video, we're going to explore the amazing collection of vehicles in the MM Park Museum near Haguenau in France. We'll start with a quick overview and then zoom in on the vehicles. I've used a GoPro on a long stick to shoot this video that gives us a slightly different view of the vehicles. No rules were broken and I did not climb on any of the vehicles. The M19 gun motor carriage is a mobile anti-aircraft gun that carries two 40mm Bofors guns. It is based on the same chassis as the M24 Chaffee light tank. Production started near the end of 1944, which meant that the vehicles were not used in World War II. They first saw action during the Korean War. The Sexton is a self-propelled artillery vehicle which carried the QF 25-pounder howitzer. The vehicle was designed in 1942 and first saw action in Italy. Just over 2,000 were built in two versions. The American M10 tank destroyer carried a 3-inch gun and was operated by a crew of 5 men. The chassis of the M10 is that of the M4A2 Sherman tank. It was also used by the British and the Free French. Next up is one of those vehicles you don't get to see that often, the LVT-4 Alligator. It's an amphibious landing vehicle that was mostly used in the Pacific, but some were also used in Europe during the Rhine crossings in March of 1945. The LVT-4 could carry 30 fully armed soldiers. It was armed with a 75mm howitzer in the turret and a 50 cal machine gun. The German Bf 108 was originally designed as a sport and touring aircraft. However, when the war began, they were also used by the Luftwaffe for personal transport and liaison. The Stoewer Type 40 was a light off-road passenger car. They were used for many things, including as a troop-level aerial defense vehicle, like the one you see here. The museum has many quirky and unusual things on display, like this, a replica U-boat conning tower. The massive Sonderkraftfahrzeug 8 was mostly used as a prime mover for heavy towed artillery or anti-aircraft guns. Around 4,000 were built and they were used by the Germans from the invasion of Poland in 1939 until the last days of the war. Besides pulling the heavy guns, it could also accommodate the crew of up to 11 soldiers. After the Germans conquered France, they found themselves in the possession of a large number of French armored vehicles. The Germans started to adapt them for their own use virtually immediately. This rather grotesque self-propelled gun is an example of this. A 10.5cm artillery gun has been bolted on the chassis of a Hotchkiss light tank. The Mercedes L1500A was an unarmored and unarmed light troop transport truck. Almost 5,000 were built and they first saw service in 1941. The British Daimler Dingo is a fast four-wheel drive reconnaissance vehicle. It has an exceptionally quiet engine and running gear and a very low silhouette. The ingenious gearbox gave 5 speeds in both directions. This means it could go as fast in reverse as it could go forward. The Universal Carrier T-16 was the United States variant of the famous British Carrier. Built by Ford of Canada, it was mostly used by the Canadian forces as an artillery tractor. Another one of those very rare vehicles in the museum is this British aircraft refueller, the Thomson Brothers P-505 Mark V. Originally introduced in 1935, these freewheelers were extensively used during World War II, and some remained in service into the 1990s. This is my favorite vehicle, the M4 High Speed Tractor. Based on the chassis of the obsolete M3 light tank, it was mostly used to tow the 155mm long tom. The driver sat in the center, and the rear compartment was used for the gun crew. Shells could be stored in the area behind them. This M5A1 high-speed tractor is the little brother of the M4 and was designed to tow artillery pieces up to 16,000 pounds, like the 105mm howitzer that is on display next to this vehicle. The M26 Pershing Tank was intended to be the replacement for the Sherman tank. It had a bigger 90mm gun, a lower hull and thicker armor than the Sherman. They entered service at the tail end of the war in March 1945. The Jagdpanzer 38 Hetzer was in service from July 1944 up until the end of the war. Based on the chassis of the Czechoslovakian Panzer 38T, it proved to be a formidable tank destroyer with sloping armor on all sides. It is similar in dimension and profile to the pre-war Panzer II, a clear breakaway from the desire to build ever bigger and heavier tanks. The Soviet T-26 light tank was designed in the 1930s, and it was the most numerous Soviet tank at the time of the German invasion in June 1941. However, its light armor and gun proved no match for the heavier German tanks. Another one of the amazing exhibits in the MM Park Museum is a naval base that has the look, feel and sound of a German bunker on the Atlantic coast. Unfortunately, I do not know what type of ship is docked. I could not find an information sign and it's not listed on their website. If you know, then please let me know and leave a comment. Two massive Russian self-propelled guns are also on display, the SU-100 and the ISU-152. Both tanks saw extensive action in World War II and remained in service well into the 1970s. Well, that's it for now. We've only covered part of the museum. There's a lot more to see and explore. Not just vehicles, but also a wide range of handguns, rifles, machine guns, and much more. If you want to visit the museum, go to their website for the exact location, admission fees, and opening times. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this virtual visit. If you did and want to see more of my videos, then please subscribe to my channel. Have a great day. Bye-bye.